The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A very welcome to St. Mary's this morning on this, the 12th Sunday after Trinity. And in our continuing reflections on John's Gospel, chapter 6, Jesus challenges those who hear him not to recognise that following Jesus isn't about a good idea or about a helpful metaphor, but about following him with our very heart and soul and mind and being, with our whole physical body. But to prepare ourselves for this act of worship, let us pray together the prayer of preparation. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments, and to live in love and peace with all. Almighty God,
our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Christ, your Son, our Lord,
who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
We sit for our readings.
Reading from the first book of Kings. Then Solomon stood before the altar of the Lord in the presence of all the assembly of Israel, and spread out his hands to heaven. He said, O Lord, God of Israel, there is no God like you in heaven above or on earth beneath. Keep in covenant and steadfast love for your servants who walk before you with all their heart, the covenant that you kept for your servant my father David, as you declared to him, you promised with your mouth, and have this day fulfilled with your hand. Therefore, O Lord, God of Israel, keep for your servant, my father David, that which you promised him, saying, there shall never fail you a successor before me to sit on the throne of Israel. If only your children look to their way to walk before me as you have walked before me. Therefore, O God of Israel, let your word be confirmed, which you promised to your servant, my brother David. But will God dwell on the earth? Even heaven and the highest heaven cannot contain it, much less this house that I have built. Have regard to your servant's prayer and his plea, O Lord my God, heeding the cry and the prayer that your servant prays to you today. That your eyes may be open night and day towards this house, the place of which you said, my name shall be there, that you may heed the prayer that your servant prays towards this place. Hear the plea of your servant and of your people Israel when they pray towards this place. O hear in heaven your dwelling place, heed and forgive. Likewise, when a foreigner who is not of your people Israel comes from a distant land, because of your name, for they shall hear your great name, your mighty hand, and your outstretched arm. When a foreigner comes and prays towards this house, then hear in heaven your dwelling place, and do according to all that the foreigner calls to you, so that all peoples of the earth may know your name and fear you, as do your people Israel. And so that they may know that your name has been invoked on this house that I have built. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Response to the psalm, blessed are those who dwell in your house. Blessed are they who dwell in your house. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord of hosts. My soul longs, indeed it faints, for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh sing for joy to the living God. Even the sparrow finds a home, and the swallow a nest for herself, where she may lay her young. At your altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God.
Blessed are they who dwell in your house.
Happy are those who live in your house, ever singing your praise. Happy are those whose strength is in you, in whose heart are the highways to Zion. As they go through the valley of Baca, they make it a place of springs. The early rain also covers it with pools.
Blessed are they who dwell in your house.
They go from strength to strength. The God of gods will be seen in Zion. O Lord God of hosts, hear my prayer. Give ear, O God of Jacob. Behold our shield, O God. Look on the face of your anointed.
Blessed are they who dwell in your house.
For a day in your courts is better than a thousand elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than live in the tents of wickedness. For the Lord God is a sun and shield. He bestows favour and honour. No good thing does the Lord withhold from those who walk uprightly. O Lord of hosts, happy is everyone who trusts in you.
Blessed are they who dwell in your house.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his power. Put on the whole armour of God, so that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For our struggle is not against the enemies of blood and flesh, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers of the present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly place. Therefore take up the whole armour of God, so that you may be able to withstand on that evil day, and having done everything, to stand firm. Stand therefore, and fasten the belt of truth around your waist, and put on the breastplate of righteousness. As shoes for your feet, put on whatever will make you ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. With all these, take the shield of faith, with which you will be able to quench all the burning arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Pray in the Spirit at all times, in every prayer and supplication. To that end, keep alert and always persevere in supplication for all the saints. Pray also for me, so that when I speak, a message may be given to me to make known with boldness the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it boldly, as I must speak. This is the word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Jesus said to the crowd, "Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate and they died. But the one who eats this bread will live forever." He said these things while he was teaching in the synagogue at Capernaum. When many of his disciples heard it, they said, "This teaching is difficult. Who can accept it?" But Jesus, being aware that his disciples were complaining about it, said to them, "Does this offend you? Then what if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh is useless. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. But among you, there are some who do not believe. For Jesus knew from the first who were the ones that did not believe, and who was the one that would betray him. And he said, 'For this reason, I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted by the Father.' Because of this, many of his disciples turned back and no longer went around with him." So Jesus asked the 12, Do you also wish to go away? Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom can we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and know that you are the only one of God. This is the word of the Lord. So it is in the spiritual warfare, where we put on the full armor of God with truth, faith, salvation through our beliefs, armed with the word of God, which is our sword. Our ammunition includes peace, prayer, petitions to saints, testimony through speech, thus becoming confident disciples. We strengthen our armor through the Eucharist. At the name of Jesus, the devil must flee. Principalities and powers are ranks of the kingdom of darkness. It is written,
that these things are real. Fallen angels that were kicked out of heaven with Lucifer, the devil himself, for their rebellion against God Almighty, as written in Luke chapter 10, verse 18. Their plan is to destroy human beings and hinder God's purpose on earth. Principalities, apart from attacking human beings, have been claimed to rule over cities. Examples are given of those of murder, kidnapping, racism, sexual perversion, gang culture, and hindrance, to name just a few. Indeed, we have seen examples of this in the mass murders in the USA, gang culture here in the UK, genocide in Rwanda and Myanmar, kidnapping that's going on in Nigeria right now, apartheid in South Africa. The list is endless. Christians need to know that we are a threat to these powers and principalities. Anyone that has joy, that is happy, grateful to God, is a threat to the devil. The devil himself knows he has no redemption plan. And as for us, our redemption is in God Almighty. God loves us. He created man in his own image. He sent his only son from heaven to die for us. When the devil sees us, he's reminded of his mistake of causing rebellion in heaven and aspiring to be God. God loves us and is not willing for any of us to perish, but that all should come to repentance. The greater you are as a tool for God, the more the attacks, as the more a threat you are to these evil powers. It is also written that the enemy is not omniscient, he doesn't know all like God, and that his attack is seasonal. Seasonal in the sense that he comes and goes and watches for your weakness before he launches his attack. We are victorious against these principalities and powers because of Jesus Christ. Colossians chapter 2, verses 14 to 15. We have heard and read of examples of exorcism by Jesus Christ, casting out devils in his name in the Bible, and I will cite the examples of Legion and of Mary Magdalene, where he cast out seven demons. A Christian may have the Holy Ghost and still come under testing from the devil, as our Lord Jesus Christ was in the wilderness. As Christians, we need to seek God for the Holy Spirit. We can plead the blood of Jesus Christ against the devil. We may not be at the level of Paul or others who cast out spirits, but we can go to God in prayer and obtain grace and mercy for him to help us in our times of need. Believe you me, we are always in need of God's grace. And we can pray ourselves into his grace. As long as our thoughts, words, actions are pure and true. To reinforce our spirits in this warfare, we need to keep praising and worshiping God and invigorate our spirits with the gift of the Eucharist, as we heard in John 6, verses 56 to 59. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me and will live. The Holy Spirit gives life in abundance. Solomon, in praising God, builds a temple where the Ark of Covenant of God was moved into, and he rightly dedicated the temple to God and prayed for God's will to reign on earth. He also prayed an all-inclusiveness of all races in the temple, and this, with glory to God, we practice here at St. Mary's. Blessed are those who dwell in God's house, for God is our refuge and fortress. Psalm 84 reinforces the need to keep praising God. Even a sparrow finds a home and a swallow a nest for herself where she places her young. I wonder what has happened to the swallows and the sparrows. Years back, one used to admire their swift flights as they go in and out of churches. I believe God is omnipotent, all-powerful, and we tap into his power through Jesus Christ, the unblemished Lamb and Pride of heaven, sacrificed for our salvation. The greatest dispensation and show of God's love for us is Jesus Christ. Happy is the one who trusts in you, O Lord, God of armies. Most of the words we've heard today, and by no means all of them, are from a Dr. Sandra Smith of the Alpha and Omega organization. God be with us.
So let's just stand now and declare together the faith we share, the words of the Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things are made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate in the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic Church. We acknowledge our baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you promised through your Son, Jesus Christ, to hear us when we pray in faith. In response to each prayer, after my words, let us pray to the Lord, is, Lord, have mercy. For the peace of the world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the Afghan people, for all refugees from places where they fear for their lives, for the victims of war and fighting in Yemen, in Ethiopia, in South Sudan, in Nigeria, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us. For governments and scientists as they work to combat COVID, for the victims of COVID and their bereaved loved ones, for those with baseless fears of vaccinations, for the mental health of all who suffer from lockdowns, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those who strive to hold together the community in Finchley, for all volunteers and workers who work for the good of others, for children on holiday, for abused families, for the victims of crime and for the police, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the Church of England and the Archbishops of Canterbury and York, for all the churches of Finchley, for those who respond to St. Paul's words of support in today's reading, for those who seek to be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his power, those who are drawn to our faith but find it difficult to believe in Jesus Christ, whom we receive in the host at communion. For all those who are persecuted for their faith, Christians, Jews, Muslims, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the sick and suffering on our prayers. For those suffering in body, mind or spirit who are known to us. For all the medical professions. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Remembering all those who have gone before us in faith, especially those of our community who died in the last 18 months during COVID. And in communion with all the saints, we commit ourselves, one another, and our whole life to Christ our God. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Just as we come to the piece, a word of clarification. Over the last 18 months, we've developed various signs of sharing the piece, which are very good because they give us something to do with our hands and offer something that does look like a sign. And we're continuing to do that as society in general has yet to get back to the shaking of hands. But the signs can be unspoken, but there's no reason at all why we can't speak that peace to one another. So as well as offering that sign of peace, do speak the peace to one another if you feel moved to today. So let's stand for the peace. We are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit, we are all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
creation, for your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given into human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation. For your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation. Blessed be God forever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have graced all things, who is sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you our holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. As we forgive those this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Thank you. Let us pray. God of all mercy, in this Eucharist, you have set aside our sins and given us your healing. Grant that we, who are made whole in Christ, may bring that healing to this broken world. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. After this service, we have coffee in the hall, so please do come and join us for that. Later on today, we have Zoom evening prayer, as usual, at 7 o'clock. In addition to our usual services this coming week, we also have a Eucharist on Tuesday morning at 9 o'clock for the Feast of St. Bartholomew. So please do come along and join us if you are able to. There are still some forms if you would like to fill in the questionnaire about the return of Junior Church. There's an electronic version available, but there are paper copies on the table by the door if you haven't yet filled one in. And as we plan the return of Junior Church, hopefully in September. So now let's stand and sing our final Keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the world.
In the name of God.